CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 8.
Class 8, lesson 1, the best Christmas present in the world, part 2, grammar in context, past and past perfect tense. Hello learners of class 8, welcome to the wonderful world of English language classroom. Learners, here we learn English, we will read, speak, write and use English for purposes and English as fun. We will play with the English language. Jeeva.
Hello everybody.
Learners and Jeeva, in the first part of the lesson, we understood the text by summarizing the lesson and doing some activities. In this part, we will do some grammar in context which appears in the lesson, in a textbook. Don't think that grammar will be very scary or very boring. We will make it interesting. Jeeva, generally grammar class is not very good, no?
Sir, some of the classes are not good.
Otherwise, you enjoy grammar also. Okay. Come on. Learners, before we move on to learn past perfect and past tense through this lesson, let me read out the objectives of this lesson. Jeeva will read some of them and I will read some of them. Here are the objectives of this lesson. At the end of this lesson, you learners will be able to read the text, the best Christmas present in the world, identify the main ideas, characters, sequence of ideas, events and relates with his personal experiences.
Respond to a variety of questions on familiar and unfamiliar texts verbally and in writing.
Use appropriate words to deduce meaning from clues in context while reading the text.
Understand time and tense. Use past and past perfect tenses in context.
Okay. The last one, that discover the forms, that is past and past perfect tense forms, and use them in speech and writing. Before we do the grammar activity, let's remind you, refresh you, your memory by reading out the events of the story in a kind of summary form. So Jeeva is starting the summary. I will join him for the second sentence likewise.
The narrator went to a junk shop in Bridport where he noticed a roll-top desk. He wanted to buy a cheaper one and bought this roll-top desk with his very little money.
He wanted to make it look good and to polish it. He removed the roll-top and pulled out the drawers.
He polished the scratches and he noticed a secret drawer underneath, and something was written there in shaky handwriting. Jim's last letter, received January 25th, 1915. To be buried with me when the time comes.
When the narrator opened the box, there was an envelope and the address written that read, Mrs. Jim MacPherson, 12 Copper Beaches, Bridport, Dorset. The date in the letter was 26th December, 1914.
The narrator read the letter. The letter was written by Jim from the battlefield in 1914 to his wife. It was on the Christmas Eve.
The letter described how the soldiers and officers from two different battling armies came together to celebrate Christmas Eve.
The British and German soldiers who were fighting against each other in World War I, till then, wanted to come together to celebrate Christmas.
Jim was the commander of the Allied forces. One of his officers, Fritz, began it by showing the white flag Wishing the other side, Happy Christmas, Tommy, Happy Christmas.
Soldiers from the other side reciprocated, responded, saying, Same to you.
They were shouting, Don't shoot lads, from both sides.
Jim and an officer from the other side sat together and ate Christmas cake and shared their drinks. They were chatting for some time and talked about their places, their civil jobs.
Soldiers from both armies played football and Jim's team won by 2-1. Then the soldiers moved to their sides.
When the narrator finished reading the letter, he folded it and put it in the envelope back.
Next morning, he drove to Bridport to find Mrs. Jim MacPherson and asked at the address. People there said she had been admitted into hospital.
The narrator went to the hospital where the very old lady was admitted. She looked very pale and was 101 years old. He handed over the letter to her.
The lady started speaking to him, thinking that it was Jim. She felt happy that he, Jim, had come back to be with her on Christmas Eve. Learners, we know that in the first part also we have seen this is the story of the best Christmas present in the world. Now, when you read the story, Jeeva, you will find how the narrator takes us, the readers, through the story. He uses some very interesting ways of telling a story. How that old lady looked, he didn't want to buy any costly one, and he didn't go to a gift shop, he went to a junk shop. That many things. Let's see how he uses the words and how he describes the events using a kind of words and sentences. Let's see. Let me read out some lines from you in order to take you to some grammar item. Come on. Learners, Jeeva, ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we will learn that. Read some sentences. Come on. Here is a sentence from the textbook. I spotted it in a junk shop in Bridport. The man in the shop said it was made in early 19th century and this one was in a bad condition. Look at the words. I spotted it in the junk shop. The man said something. It was in bad condition. This learners, you know very well, Jeeva, what tense it is written? Time? Past time or present time? I spotted it.
In the past.
Okay. The man said is also in past. Okay. Now, I'm going to read out a small funny story like. Let me read out. A tall man entered the room. He had to bend himself to enter the room. As he went near the fan, people in the room were scared that his head might hit the fan. They wanted him to be careful. He said that he was aware of it, but he did not notice the bulb on the other side and he hit it. Everyone laughed. Learners, let me read out to you again. A tall man entered the room. He had to bend himself to enter the room. When he went near the fan, people in the room were scared that his head might hit the fan. They warned him to be careful. They said that he was aware of it. But he did not notice the bulb on the other side. He hit it. Everyone laughed. Jeeva and learners, look at it. All the actions here in the story took place in the past. Jeeva, am I right?
Yes, sir.
A tall man entered the room. He had to bend. He went near the fan. People were scared. They warned him. He did not notice the bulb and he hit the bulb. So this is what? Everything is said in past. Everything said, we use simple past tense. Now look at these sentences from the story. The best Christmas present in the world. A veneer had lifted almost everywhere. Both fire and water had their toll on the desk. Jeeva, look at the sentence there. The veneer had lifted almost everywhere. Then look at next one. the fire and water had taken their toll on the desk. The veneer had lifted. It also happened in past tense, you know?
Yes, sir.
Had lifted. He must have said veneer had lifted. Instead of veneer had lifted, he must have said veneer lifted almost everywhere. Why did he say had lifted? Because
it was in past tense.
Past tense. But instead of simple past, he has used something else. Had lifted. Why? Because veneer had its damages before the narrator bought it. There are two actions in the past. Narrator bought it. The veneer had lifted it everywhere before he bought it. Okay? Now, there are two actions in the past. One action is set in the past. Another action is set in past perfect. Okay, don't bother about the rules, learners. We'll come back to it again. I'm going to read some more sentences. Jeeva will read for me these four sentences. Come on.
1. Last week, I told my friend that I would visit them. 2. Last year, I visited Mumbai. It was a great experience. 3. I was the captain of a school hockey team when I was in class 11. 4. I lived in Bengaluru during 2002 to 2004.
Okay. Look at the first sentence. Last week I told my friend I would visit them. Told was in past tense. Okay. Last year I visited Mumbai. When did I visit?
Last year.
Okay. I was the captain of a school when I was in class 11. When was my captainship?
In class 11.
Now I have moved out of it. I lived in Bangalore. When did I live? 2002
to 2004.
So, in the past. Whatever thing we have referred to, we use to refer to, we use in the past, we use simple past. Now, if there are two actions continuously in the past, what will you do? Let us see. For example, let me tell you, Jeeva. When I entered the room, the technical person had already arrived. So he had already arrived means he was here before I came. Am I right?
Okay. Yes.
So if there are two actions, what will you do? Come on, learners. Let me read out some of the sentences to you. I will request Jeeva to read. Then one after another. When you read the first one, stop for a while. I have to say something. Come on.
1. Our teacher has told us to submit assignment, but he forgot it.
Come on. Our teacher had told us to submit the assignment, but he forgot it. When did he forgot it first? He told you to do the assignment first?
Yes, sir.
Then he forgot it later?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, read the sentence again.
Our teacher has told us to submit assignment, but he forgot it.
Okay. He had told you to submit it, but he forgot. So, learners, if there are two continuous actions in the past, for the earlier action, we use past perfect. The teacher had told us to submit the assignment, but he forgot it later. So, for the first action, we use past perfect. Come on. Next sentence.
2. Rahul met his friend at the station as he had promised.
When did he meet his friend at the station? When did he promise? Before he met him?
In the station.
Okay. He promised that he would meet him. Her promise was the earlier action. So, for the earlier action, we use past perfect. Next one.
Vanita had finished her work and went to play.
When did she finish her work?
Before she went to play.
Very good. So, for the first action, we use past perfect. Okay. When I reached the station, the train had already left. Which is the first action?
The train had already left when he reached.
Okay, let me ask you. Learners, when I reached the station, the train had already left. Which is the first action?
The train had already left.
So, for the first action, past perfect, had left. When I finished the work, the teacher had already left. Which is the first action?
Had already left.
The teacher left, then you finished. Okay? He wrote answer to the last question, the bell had already rang. Which one is the first action?
The bell had already rung.
Okay. Learners, when there are two actions in the past, you may use past perfect for the first action, past for the second action. The police officers saw them violating the traffic before they had reached the point. What is the first action?
Before they had reached the point.
Okay. I had promised to help her, but I could not do it. Which is the first action?
I had promised.
Promising. Fine. Now, last one. When Gandhiji had called for action, the people of this country supported him.
When Gandhiji had called.
That was the first action. Gandhiji called the action. Okay, now, this is to make you understand. Some sentences are narrated, told. Now, I'm going to ask you, Jeeva. We will do some activities. I'm going to read out a sentence with past perfect and past. And there will be, I will give you three options for each blank. You will have to supply the correct one. Come on. The school assembly dash become, became or had become quite well before the headmaster reached or had reached. Come on, Jeeva.
Sir, I'm not sure, but I think it's became.
No, you read the whole sentence and tell.
The school assembly became quite well before the headmaster had reached.
Which action took place first?
Had reached.
No. School assembly.
School had become.
Yeah.
So can I repeat?
Yeah. Now you got the point. Yeah, go ahead.
The school assembly had become quiet well before the headmaster reached.
Very good. Come on, you got the point, you know. The school assembly had become quiet well before the headmaster reached. So the first action is the assembly became quiet. All right. Now, let me read the second sentence. When I reached or had reached the station, the train dash arrived or had arrived. Come on. Which is the first action?
When I reached the station, the train had arrived.
Very good. The train arrived before I reached. Very good. Well done. When I reached the station, the train had already arrived. Come on. Third one. When I saw or had seen him, he moved or had moved out of the hostel.
When I saw him, he had moved out of the hostel.
Very good. Before he saw him, he moved first. Okay. When I saw him, he had moved out of the hotel. Next. I noticed the difference before. They had told me. Come on.
I had noticed the difference before they told me.
Okay. The first action is I noticed. So, I had noticed the difference before they told me. Okay. Now, when I entered the house, my brother goes or went or had gone to play.
When I entered the house, my brother had gone to play.
When I entered the house, brother had gone to play. Last one in this section. When our captain asked the team to exercise, many of us had started doing it.
When a captain asked the team to exercise, many of us had started doing it.
Okay, because as he was saying, you started doing it. Come on. When the captain asked the team to exercise, many of us had started doing it. Thank you, Jeeva. You got the point. If there are two actions continuously in the past, the first action, you can say it in past perfect, that is had plus third form of the verb. And the second action, you can say it in past. Now, we are going to do some more. So, before we do, let me ask Jeeva to read some sentences so that you get the idea of how past perfect and past perfect tense are used.
I got up at 7 a.m. yesterday. I studied in another school last year. I played a lot of hockey when I was in school.
Fine. Jeeva, what are these? When are these actions taking place? In past. Is it?
Yes, sir.
They are different actions, so simply set in past tense. Now, we are going to reread the sentences which you have done. Some of them are repeated, some of them will some of them are new. So Jeeva, let's look at it, look at the sentences again, listen to the sentences again, and you have to answer it. When the school assembly had become quite well before the headmaster reached or had reached.
The school assembly had become quiet well before the headmaster had reached.
Both you are using had.
Sorry, sir. The school assembly had become quiet well before the headmaster reached.
Fine. Well done. Good. Learners, it may be slightly confusing, but you have to be careful, as Jeeva did. When I had reached the station, the train arrived or had arrived?
When I reached the station, the train had arrived.
Very good. When I saw or had seen him, he had moved out of the hotel.
When I saw him, he had moved out of the hotel.
Okay. When I had noticed the difference before, they told me.
I had noticed the difference before they told me.
When I entered the house, my brother had gone to play.
When I entered the house, my brother had gone to play.
When a captain asked the team to exercise, many of us had started doing it.
When a captain asked the team to exercise, many of us had started doing it.
Very good. Well done, Jeeva. Fine. Now, very easy and classic example for past perfect and past tense together is, learners, when I reached the station, the train had already left. So the first action is train left first, then you reached. Come on, let's discover the rules of this past perfect tense. Learners, Jeeva, we use past perfect tense to refer to an action, the earlier action in the past before an action. There are two actions in the past, learners. When I reached the station, the train had already left. Jeeva said it, and you also must have known. When I reached the station, in the statement, when I reached the station, the train had already left. The train left first, then you reached. So, for the earlier action, the action which took place first, that is before an action, we use past perfect. So we need not bother much about rule, but we know by using it. We have used a lot of sentences in context. So we said, when our captain asked the team to exercise, many of us had started doing it. So the earlier action, the first action in past perfect, second action in past. So you may ask, sir, how will I use past perfect alone? Sir, it was a time when everything had been one. So when you use past perfect, come on, learners and Jeeva, ready? We'll do another set of activities. Okay. Come on. When I reached the station, the train left or had left?
When I reached the station, the train had left.
Very good. When I entered the theater, he started or had started his speech.
When I entered the theater, he had started his speech.
Gandhiji had earned the respect of people even before India had got its independence.
Gandhiji had earned the respect of people even before India got its independence.
Very good. My brother had started doing a job even before he completed or had completed the degree.
My brother had started doing a job even before he completed his degree.
Very good. Jeeva, well done. What we need to learn in this lesson is, past perfect tense is used with an action before an action. That is, there are two actions. Maybe something happened later, and the earlier action we use past perfect. When I reached the station, the train had already left. Jeeva, thank you very much. Learners, let me also thank you. But let me tell you how we learn the reading of the text, also the grammar. Come on, learners, there are a lot of activities we are doing, summarizing, true or false, multiple choice, there are many, many things. We are done in first part now also. So please go through it again, read the lesson again, and do the activities at the end of the book. Then notice the form. Form means the grammatical form. When I reached the station, the train had already left. When I entered the house, my brother had gone to play. First action. So please notice this, and there are lots of activities in your textbook, and you also may have noticed, and you should see it. Otherwise, there is QR code, quick reference code in your textbook with that dot dot thing, kind of small square. So please decode it, and you will see lot of activities available in the textbook. And also this textbook is available as audiobook. You may listen to it very well. After reading, if you listen after reading, it will be very interesting, and your vocabulary enhances, your language learning actually taking place. Learners, we hope that you have enjoyed this lesson. I have not told my name so far. I am Meghanathan. You may send your queries, your responses to my email ID, also the email ID of Central Institute of Education Technology and CRT. Let me tell you the my email ID. Here it is, rama_meghanathan@yahoo.com. You may send your query so that we will continue to do. You may do even speaking lesson, writing lesson, many more things. So learners, here are some of the tips for you to improve your English language, Jeeva. Listen to some radio news or television news, preferably Doordarshan news, because they are very neat and clean. They don't hype things. So then read a newspaper every day, 5-10 minutes or half an hour, and keep reading some novel in your language, mother tongue, as well as English, so that our reading improves. And one more thing, please read the English language lesson before the teacher takes up in the classroom. That will be very interesting. You will be able to brainstorm, think about the language. Thank you very much, learners. Jeeva, let me thank you. Learners, we will meet you in the next lesson.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. So keep learning, keep reading. Learning never stops.
You are just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo and produced by Vandana Arimardhan. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.